Like millions of Americans, you are probably being bombarded with those political robo-texts from campaigns asking for donations or asking for your vote. The call blocking service RoboKiller estimates that Americans nationwide received, look at this, 253 million political robo-texts and more than 1 million robo-calls just last December alone. And now just over a week till the election, millions more are expected. Messaging from campaigns and interest groups vying for your attention. Political text outreach service RumbleUp is predicting the total number of political messages sent through Election Day could reach around 25 billion. So what can you do to try to fight back against that onslaught? Joining me now, cybersecurity expert Dave Hatter. Dave, great to see you. I'm sure you have also received these texts, these calls. How much of an increase in this type of spam are we seeing now compared to maybe years past?
Well, Nicole, as always, thanks for having me on. And I think it's increased because more people use text, right? I mean, if you're someone who wants to reach people and you want to do it in a cost-effective manner, text is one of the easiest, best ways to do that because, let's face it, more people probably use text now than they do email, or certainly it's going to be real similar. And I just remind folks, it's very easy to send a text message at scale. It can be hard to verify if the sources are legitimate. That's one of the reasons why people should be wary about this, not mention just the constant bombardment with phone calls and texts. So, yeah, I think that the numbers you show don't surprise me at all. I mean, who isn't getting more texts? And in a heated political season like this, it just makes sense that they're going to use this tool to try to reach people.
Oh, yeah. I mean, 25 billion potentially when all is said and done. Dave, what should we do? What can we do? Should we be blocking? Should we reply stop? Because sometimes that's an option. Should we just ignore it altogether?
Well, the good news, Nicole, is you have a bunch of options. You're going to have to decide what makes the most sense for you. But, you know, my first advice would be if you see something and it's obviously fake, right? You can forward it to 7726, which is a number set up by the FCC to specifically report things that seem bogus. You know, I would remind folks, if you reply stop, right? Theoretically, if you're dealing with any kind of reputable person at the other end of that text, they're going to give you a way to opt out. But remember, bad guys know that folks can't always tell if something's legit or not. And if you do reply, if you send stop to unsubscribe or whatever their opt-out is, you have now just told the spammer at the other end of the line that you have that's a legitimate number. Keep in mind, Nicole, it's easy to write a program that can just generate phone numbers, or they get phone numbers from these large data dumps and blast these things out at scale. If you do reply, you're guaranteeing they know you're legit. So, you know, my advice to people is to not do that unless you know for sure you're replying to a legitimate person at the other end, because you're just guaranteeing they're going to sell that to other folks. You do have options. You know, whether you're on Android or Apple, they have a way to block these to some extent. You can go to your carrier. All of the major carriers have some options to block these. And, you know, if you really hate this sort of thing, you can download an app like RoboKiller or NomoRobo or Aura, which are specifically designed to try to stop this stuff. So you do have options. The FCC has some great resources, or you can go to like the Apple website and get tips for your phone or Android, if it's an Android phone, on exactly how to block these things.
Absolutely, and those things certainly work, although sometimes some things can get through. Dave, some people get so irritated with this, they actually contemplate switching to a brand new phone number. Is that too extreme? Because isn't it eventually just going to come up on the new number anyway?
Well, I think that's a valid point, Nicole. Yeah, eventually they're going to find you wherever you're at, right? They're buying these phone numbers from legitimate sources, data brokers. They're getting them from data leaks. So, yeah, even if you switch to a new phone, they're probably eventually going to find you. You know, I find it irritating, but I could tell you, like, I don't answer the phone from any number I don't recognize. I'm not going to reply to any of these texts because I don't know if they're legit or not. And in general, I'm trying to use my phone to block these things. You know, if you get a text, you can, on an Apple phone anyway, slide left and basically say report. So it's not that difficult to cut down the volume. Again, I would encourage people, though, be careful. Understand when you look at a text, you can't by the naked eye know if the number it came from is legit, if it has links in it, if they're legit or not. And again, if you interact with it in any way, at a minimum, you've told the other end there is a living person at that number, and they're going to keep sending it to you.
And they will keep sending it to you. So, yes, just try to ignore the best we can. 8 more days to go. All right, cybersecurity expert Dave Hatter, thank you so much.
My pleasure. Thank you.